Now, the impact of the climate crisis on people and nature across the planet are real and will only intensify in the coming decades. That's according to a report by Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, while advocating increased actions to become more resilient to the changing climate. Our correspondent Esther Mokwarela examines this issue even as the world continues to cut down carbon emissions in the face of rising global temperatures.
Intense heat waves, drought, wildfires, storms and floods are some of the impact of climate change, which are now irreversible. And scientists say, without action, worse is coming.
Currently, nearly 3.5 billion people are highly vulnerable to climate impacts. And this is projected to increase from 50% to 75% by the end of the century.
In a new report authored by hundreds of the world's top climate scientists, the window of opportunity for action is brief and rapidly closing. And in the words of UN Secretary General, delay is death.
There is no kind way to put it. The 1.5 degree goal is on life support. It is in intensive care.
In addition to these concerns, the report stated that if warming reaches 4 degrees Celsius, half of all plants and animals will be threatened with extinction. Many coastal communities most vulnerable to climate change due to rising sea levels could disappear in a few decades.
Our houses, even the central mosque of the community, everything has been washed away. If you go down to the other side now, after about four or five souls.
But to deal with this climate crisis, which scientists say could affect the existence of mankind, investment in adaptation measures, among other strategies, experts say need to be put in place to reduce carbon footprint and preserve this planet for everyone.
People need to be conscious, people need to be aware. So where is my food waste going to? So if I know that this, my food waste goes to the dump site, it causes methane, gas, you know, and all of that, so why should I still contribute to, you know, the crisis, the climate crisis?
Stop extracting more coal, more gas, more oil, and burning these resources, because this is what is taking up the space in the atmosphere that can safely be occupied by greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide and the rest.
While the science and solutions are clear on how to combat climate change, even as the world tries to move away from fossil fuels and cut down carbon emissions by 2050, it is also believed that investing in education, health systems, and social justice could help people cope with the impacts of rising temperatures if we are to guarantee a lifeline for the next generation. Esther Mokwariola, TVC News, Lagos.